minor tuning. And the chords in this first part is going to be B minor, G, the kind of G where you hold the two up here on the third. We're calling this the, you know, like the nut or whatever. So now I'm saying third fret, which is actually your fourth fret, but you hold these two notes down. So B minor, G, D, A. So it'll be like, okay, so the B minor, hold the B minor like regularly, and go 5, 4, 3, because you know I finger pick, but you can use your, if you, I'm not sure if you do that now or if you're just using your flat pick, but just go string wise, go 5, 4, 3, and then go to this G chord. Hit the 6th string, then the 4th string, then the 2nd string, and the 3rd string. So B minor, change real quick. Hit the 6th string again before you go to the D chord. So four, three, two on the D, and then go to the A, and then go 5, 4, 3. And then do it again. And then the song starts basically the same riff for a good while through that verse while he's singing, you know, just. Okay, let's play along with it for a little bit. I've got a chart here for you. I'm going to send this to you. This is a number chart, and we might talk about this here in a little bit, how the number chart works. If you don't know, we might have a lesson on that later, or you just, you know, owe me anything if I'm going to teach you that part, but I'm just trying to get into this song as quickly as we can. Let's play along with the song, and I'll kind of stop it as we go. Basically, the same thing all the way through the verse. There's about halfway through this second part of the verse. It has a little A sus. So you can hold that A. You know, the A is on the 2nd fret of the 2nd string, 3rd string, 4th string. So sometimes you can make it like that, or you can make it like I do. I kind of make it what looks like a D7 chord. You know, I've got the 3rd finger, and then 1st finger, and then 2nd finger. And for that A sus, I just put that 4th finger down. So let's play along with the song and see what we can do. We'll get to the solo as well. Oh, what I forgot to tell you, kind of mute that with your right hand, you know. Kind of lay the palm down a little bit. Don't mute it too much, but. Okay, let's start again. And then the A. It's the A sus for, I'm counting this in two. One, two, one, two, one, two. So A sus for a couple of measures, then hit A twice. One, two, one, two. I'm gonna be a. Now we're gonna go G twice. A, B minor, A, G, A, G, I'm sorry, D, A. Here's the second half of the chorus. G, D, A, B minor. What I'm doing on that, I'm hitting the, you don't have to hit that D over F sharp if you don't want to. You know, I'm hooking the thumb over there on the 2nd fret. D, G, and a little pause. D, G, D, G, and then it goes back to the turn, which is the turn means the same thing as the intro. Okay. let's do the chorus along with them here. Start with a G and then go to D. And on that, I dropped my pick down here somewhere. Anyway, it's one of those A sus, back to A, take the finger that's on the second string, like A2 in the back of the A. Okay, as soon as I find that pick, here we go. Okay, this should be about halfway through the chorus. Now let me back it up just a touch. So the intro, pretty much again. The second half of this. So this is like an A and a quick D. So I'm leaving my first finger here and putting the second finger on the second string. And the third finger up here on the fourth string. And then back to the verse again. We're not going to catch everything here. You know, we're not going to catch everything in there. Well, what he's doing, he's playing off this E flat, which is down here. If you made like a, you know, a G chord and you moved it up, and this were your capo finger or your bar finger, all the way up here to the 11th fret and the 10th fret and then 11th fret up here in the first string, made what looks like a G chord, and put this finger all the way down over the 8th fret. That's where he's doing some of his solo stuff. Some little fills going on there. Like I said, I'm not going to show you everything like that, but we are going to get to the solo here pretty quick. A sus. A. B. C, E minor, A, go back to C, G, E minor, okay, not that you're interested in what the chords are doing here, but it's kind of a staccato G chord, da 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 A. Again. Okay, so the solo starts up here on your 13th fret. Okay, this is one of these where you're going to have to bend a 3 fret deal. You're on the 13th fret, it's a C note. you want that to sound like the E flat note. So it's a 3-fret bend. You don't see those too many times. Hotel California has one in there, but so it's going to be a require a little bit of a, you know, a strength thing. You hit it one time, and again, you want it to sound like this note. Only hit it once. You're going to hear three notes. You're going to go back 2 frets to your 11th fret, then your 13th fret. Okay. Go to your 3rd string, 12th fret, same deal. You want this G to bend up 3 frets to sound like a B flat. And then back to the 10th fret, and then the 12th fret. So basically the same riff, just you're in a different spot. 13th fret, 11th fret. Go up a string and back a fret. Okay. Let's hear part of that again. Now this next part will be on your 8th fret, 3rd string. Excuse me. Now go up to the 10th fret, hammer on. 3rd string, 8th fret, hammer on the 10th fret. And then drop down to the 8th fret, 2nd string. And we're going to hammer on from the 8th fret to the 11th fret. So this is 8 to 10 on the 3rd string. Now this is a 2-fret bend, a whole step. So now you're on the 8th, after you do the hammer on, hit it again and bend it 2 frets worth. And then this 3rd string, 10th fret. Okay, let's hear that. Okay, hopefully you got that. And that goes again. It repeats again. There's a little pause. And then we start again. And the ending of this is different. Okay. So what we're gonna do, second time through. That bends like it did before, you kind of hold it up there. This is one of those things where now your first finger is gonna be on the 10th fret, your third finger is gonna be on the 13th fret, and they bend into a unison thing. You want this note here, you want this note to sound like this one. So I'm on the 10th fret of the 1st string and a 13th fret of the 2nd string.
Now move all this up a
half step. And these are whole step bends. And the last part of this, go up to the 15th fret. So first finger is on the 10th fret, and then we're gonna be on the 11th fret, and excuse me, it'll be the 13th fret. So 10, 11, skip 12. 10, 11, 13. And this moves up with it kind of in tandem each time.
Okay, let's see if we can play along with that.
More like the rhythm of it. Okay.